My dear friends, this is ARD, your accounting coach, and the topic of the day is IAS 36, Impairment of Assets. Impairment means a permanent reduction in the value of non-current assets, or it can be in current assets as well, but we'll be discussing here the effect of non-current assets. Whenever there is a reduction or permanent reduction in the value of non-current assets, the assets are said to be impaired. Now, before moving on to calculate the impairment loss, first we need to discuss what does impairment means and what does revaluation means. There is another concept you may have heard of previously known as revaluation of non-current assets. Sometimes we revalue the assets, whether it is upward revaluation or downward devaluation, and sometimes we use impairment. Now, what is the difference between the two and when are these two concepts supposed to be used? See, if we apply IAS 16, property, plant and equipment, which relates to non-current assets, IAS 16 gives us a choice. Whether do we want to keep our assets on historical cost basis, which is known as a cost model, or whether we need to keep our assets on revaluation basis, which is known as fair value model. So IAS 16 allows us the choice of two models. We can use a cost model or we can use a fair value or revaluation model. In a revaluation model or fair value model, we keep the asset on market value, and whenever this market value increases, we revalue our asset. The entry is non-current asset debit and revaluation reserve credit. Or whenever there is a decrease in the value, we make a reverse entry. Basically, asset will be credited and revaluation reserve will be debited. So this is a revaluation model in which we do not impair an asset, we just revalue it to reflect the current market value. But in the case of impairment, my dear students, impairment is applied in the case of cost model. Whenever we are using cost model, we are supposed to keep the asset on historical cost, and we are not supposed to increase its value if there is an increase in market value of that asset. But what we need to do, we need to check for impairment every year. Minimum every year we need to check, but if during the year there is a more chance or there are circumstances that are leading to the reduction in the value and permanent reduction in the value of non-current asset, what we need to do, we need to impairment test it for between the year as well. So I hope now you understand impairment is only used where the company is following a cost model. In a cost model, we do not revalue the asset and we do not use the revaluation reserve account, but only we need to use the impairment loss. So in the case of impairment, there is no upward, there is no such thing as impairment gain. There is only impairment loss. According to prudence concept, if the asset has lost its value during the year, we need to record that loss immediately. But if the asset has increased its value, we do not account for the increment in value. Okay, now let us discuss what does impairment means. Impairment loss can be understood with the help of this simple flowchart. There are two values. First, there is carrying value and then there is a recoverable amount. What does carrying value means? Carrying value means net book value. I hope you know how to calculate net book value. Net book value is calculated as cost minus accumulated depreciation, also known as provision for depreciation. Carrying value or net book value is basically the value of non-current asset that is in our books after deducting all the accumulated depreciation. This is the carrying value or net book value. A carrying value is compared with its recoverable amount. Recoverable amount means the amount that could be recovered from the use of the asset or from the sale of the asset. So recoverable amount can be calculated as greater of these two values. Which are the two values? First is fair value less cost to sell. This is also known as net realizable value. Fair value less cost to sell. Fair value means the value at which the asset will be sold right now in current condition. This is the fair value or market value. Less cost to sell means if we want to sell the asset, do we need to incur some expenses in order to make the sale? What are the expenses? Maybe there is a selling cost, maybe there is a delivery cost, maybe first we need to repair the non-current asset. So this is what we known as fair value less cost to sell. This is net realizable value. And the second value which we need to consider is value in use. Value in use means if we will be using the asset in near future, what is the amount of present value that we can earn? Now, value in use is mostly given in the exam. If it's not given, we need to be calculate. How we need to calculate it? We must be given future cash flows. That if I'm using this asset, this will benefit me for maybe coming 5 years. So 5 years down the road, what are the benefits? What are the inflows that this asset will generate? So all that inflows will be discounted. If you have studied investment appraisal previously, you have calculated NPV, net present value. So what we need to do, we need to discount all the future values in order to bring present value. So in A2 accounting syllabus, investment appraisal, calculating NPV is also part of the syllabus, and this is also for A2 accounting. But if you are studying these ISs for some other qualification, and if the investment appraisal or discounting you haven't studied it, or if it's not part of your course, you must be given value in use in the exam. So we need to see which is the higher value, whether fair value less cost to sell or whether value in use. We will be using higher of both. And for example, if fair value less cost to sell is greater than value in use, then the fair value less cost to sell or NRV is our recoverable amount. So recoverable amount needs to be checked with carrying value. If carrying value is greater than recoverable amount, the difference between the two is said to be impairment loss. Now let us write some figures in order to make it better sense. Let's say we are a logistics company such as DHL. So what we are doing, we are a courier company. We have an asset, for example, a motor van that costs us 100,000. Or there is a cost, or it is a net book value, doesn't matter. In our books, a van is showing in $100,000, and now we need to see whether that van is impaired or not. Now we need to calculate this carrying amount, we need to compare this carrying amount with the recoverable amount, which is greater of these two values. For example, if we sell the van right now, it can be sold for 80,000, but the problem is that van is not in a good condition to sell, and if we want the van to generate 80,000 from its sale, we need to incur expense such as 25,000. We need to repair that van. For example, this van has been in collision and has been damaged severely, and we need to repair or dent or paint that van and repair its engine for 25,000. It will be sold in 80,000 after incurring cost of 25,000. So what is the net realizable value of that van? The net realizable value is 55. Means if we sell the van after repair, we can fetch 55,000 out of it, or if we use the van, for example, we can earn 65. So how does this possible? For example, if we use the van after maybe repair or right in this condition, if we use the van, we can generate 65,000 in the long term. Means, for example, if the remaining useful life of this van is 10 years and we'll be earning X and X values of revenue and number of revenues from this, and after discounting this, we'll be getting a value of 65. Now, what do you suggest? Which is the better course of action? Whether we use the van in order to generate revenues of 65, or we should sell the van in this condition? Obviously, the greater value is 65,000. So out of these two value, we will be choosing value in use, which is greater in value. So this 65,000 becomes a recoverable amount. Means we can recover 65,000. We can recover 65,000 from the use of this van. Now we will be comparing carrying value with the recoverable amount. Carrying value is greater 100 and recoverable amount is less, that is 65. What is the difference between the two? The difference is 35,000, which is known as impairment loss. This means the van which is in our books, that is statement of financial position, it is shown as 100,000, but the actual value that can be recovered from sale or maybe use is 65. If the carrying value is greater than recoverable amount, then the difference is impairment loss. So I hope students, you are understanding the what are the concepts underlying impairment. Now let us make modify this example. If in our books the carrying value is 60,000, for example, in our books the net book value of the stated van is 60,000, but 65,000 can be recovered from its use or from its sale, whichever is higher. We can recover 65, but in our books this van is already on a lesser value, lower value, that is 60,000. If the carrying value is not greater than recoverable amount, because carrying value is 60 and recoverable amount is 65, this means there is no such thing as impairment. There is no such thing as impairment gain in this IS. There is only impairment loss. So right now, if the van is already on 60,000 and we can recover more than from the value that is written in our accounts, there is no such thing as impairment loss. We didn't need to do nothing. But if we'll go to previous example, if the carrying value is greater than recoverable amount, the impairment loss is 35,000, and that loss shall be booked immediately as an expense in income statement, and the asset should be written down by 35,000, and the asset should be written down to 65,000. So I hope students, you understood the concepts behind impairment loss. You can also go through my other videos if you like this video, and kindly do share it with other accounting students. And if you haven't subscribed my channel, now is the right time to do it. Thank you.